Hello children. Okay, see, in this class let us start a new lesson. So that is based on the food items. Okay, so we are eating food items. We are that is from that food items we can taste sour, bitter, spicy, these are all. Okay, so based on that taste we can observe. So sour taste, what is that sour taste? That is due to on acids. That is due to on acids. And what is bitter in taste? That is based on bases. Okay, you all know what is salt. Okay, what is salt? So these are the tastes we are, that is we can observe from we are eating. Okay, that is sour based on acids and bitter based on bases and salts. So let us see briefly about acids, bases and salts in this lesson. Okay, so what are the properties and based on the reactions we can see in this lesson. Okay, so what is the lesson? Acids, bases and salts. Okay, our second lesson. So this is our second lesson in chemistry. Okay, in chemistry this is our second lesson. So sour in taste, that is based on, that is due to acids. Okay, so now let us see the properties of acids. So before that let us know, so if we are eating, overeating, okay, overeating, not eating, overeating, so we like the food much more, so we are eating more food. So based on that, more food, so we are eating more food means that starts from acidity. Okay, so based on acid level is more. Okay, so while acid level is more means we are getting the acidity. So how to reduce that acidity in our body? How to reduce? So we have a homemade solutions. Okay, that is lemon juice and baking soda solution, so vinegar solution, these are all we are taking to reduce that acidity, or we are taking antacids from the medical shops. Okay, so what is based on that antacid tablets and lemon juice and this baking soda solution, vinegar, these are bases. Okay, so while we are taking bases, it reduces the acidity in our body. Okay, so you know this small thing. Okay, this is based on acids and bases contents. Okay, so now let us move on to the properties of acids. Okay, so what is the properties of acids? The first property, that is sour in taste. Okay, properties of acids. Properties of acids. Okay, first property, that is sour in taste. Sour in taste. Okay, so and then it have sour taste and the blue litmus paper changes into red. So we are taking any acid contained food, that in that the blue litmus paper is changes into red litmus. Okay, red color. Blue litmus paper is changes into red color. What is the second property of acids? Okay, blue litmus paper changes into red. Changes into red. And red litmus paper, there is no changes on the red litmus paper. So acids doesn't act on the red litmus paper. Okay. So from that we know that content, that property is acids. Okay. So acids are sour in taste and acids of changes blue litmus into red color. Okay. And red litmus paper, there is no change in the acids. Okay. So there is no action on the red litmus paper. Okay. And then acids are given hydroxyl ions. Okay. Sorry. Hydrogen ions. Hydrogen ions in the aqueous solution. So bases are given hydroxyl ions in the aqueous solution. Here acids are given hydrogen ions. Okay, H plus ions. Acids are given H plus ions. ions. H plus means hydrogen ions. Hydrogen ions in the aqueous solution. Aqueous solution. Okay, aqueous solution. So here these are the properties for acids. Okay, that we are seeing here. Indicators also indicates the acids and bases separately. Okay, so what is indicators? Litmus paper. So other than this, we have more indicators. Okay, so that also we can see in this class. Okay, so first properties of acids. What are the properties of acids? Sour in taste and blue litmus paper changes into red and H plus ions in the aqueous solution. So acids gives H plus hydrogen ions in the aqueous solution. Okay, and then all acids are same in content? No. Okay, acids are different. Okay, so based on the solution, so we can differentiate acids in that is strong acids and weak acids. Okay, we can differentiate that strong acids and weak acids. Okay, based on the concentration. So the artificial acids which we are making in the laboratories, that we are saying it as strong acids. That is hydrochloric acid, HCl, sulfuric acid, H2SO4, and methanoic acid, CHP, COOH. Okay. So here OH comes on. Hydroxyl ions, but here hydrogen ions it gives in the aqueous solution. So methanoic acid. So these are all comes under the strong acids, and nitric acid also they get in both. Okay, so this acid comes on strong or weak. So both it should be comes under. So while it should be in concentrated, this is a strong acid. It should be a dilute. It is comes under the weak acid. So, but we should mention this in the weak acids. Okay. So, HNO3 is a strong acid. Nitric acid. See, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, and nitric acid. These are comes under the strong acids. Okay. And weak acids. We can say it is a lactic acid. Okay. That is natural acids. Lactic acid. Methanoic acid. Okay, if it is a dilute acid, methanoic acid and oxalic acid. Oxalic acid also comes from the plant products. Okay, oxalic acids. Okay, and formic acid, this is not comes under the weak acid by dilution. And then you should come to know what is concentrated and what is diluted. What is concentrated and what is diluted? Okay, so you all clear in this, students? See, what is the properties of acids? Sour in taste and blue litmus to paper changes into red, and then H plus ions in the aqueous solution. Hydrogen ions is given in the aqueous solution, and then strong acids. Strong acids are made in the laboratories. Okay, that is hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acids, and then weak acids. Lactic acid, methanoic acid, and oxalic acids are weak acid. So how we are classifying it as strong acids and weak acids based on the concentration level of the acids. So what is the concentration level? The dilution of the acids. So concentrated acids. So concentrated acids, we can say that is a strong acids. Concentrated acids are strong acids. Here in this, acid content is more acid plus less amount of water. Less amount of water. More amount of acid plus less dilute acids. Dilute acids. In dilute acids, that is more water and less amount of acid. Okay, so this is for example, we are using so many products we are using to clean our houses, okay, or any other things which is in our home, okay, in our surroundings. So we should dilute that products and then we can use, or otherwise the burning sensation in our hands or in our skin, okay, because of more amount of acid. We are adding more amount of water to that products, okay, that byproducts. We can't observe that burning sensation because of dilute acids, more water plus less amount of acids. So we don't use that. If we are using as it is, that byproducts, we are observing the burning sensation in our skin, okay. So that is very harmful to our body, okay. So we don't use the more acid content products, okay. So now let us move on to the another thing, that is properties of bases. Properties of bases. So you all know children, that is based on the acids, we can say the properties of bases also. So the taste of bases, what is the taste of bases? What is the taste of bases? Bitter in taste. Bases. Okay, the first one property is bitter in taste. Bitter in taste. And bases we can touch. If we can touch acids, it is a burning sensation, or it should be burn our hands also. But bases we can touch easily. How to touch? What is the observation of touching the bases? Soapy to touch. Okay. So second property is soapy to touch. Okay. Soapy to touch. And third property. So blue litmus paper changes into red in acids. Here red litmus paper changes into blue in color. Bases are changes red litmus paper into blue. So acids are changes blue litmus paper into red. Here in bases, blue red litmus paper changes into blue. Okay, and this bases given hydroxyl ions in the aqueous solution. Okay, so these are the properties for bases. Okay, so bitter in taste, soapy to touch, and red litmus paper into blue. Red litmus paper changes into blue in color, and then hydroxyl ions. Bases given hydroxyl ions in the aqueous solution. So these are the properties of bases. Understood, children? What are the properties of acids and what are the properties of bases? These are the physical properties for acids and bases. So these are the physical properties for acids and bases. And we can say this bases as alkalis. Okay, we read in our last class also. Okay, in 9th standard also I told you this. Okay, I thought. Okay, see here. Bases we can say it is an alkalis. Why? Because it is mixes with water. Okay, so that is soluble in water. So probably all the bases are soluble in water. So we can say it is an alkalis. Bases we can say it is an alkalis. Why we are saying alkalis? Bases we can say it is an alkalis. Why? Means probably all the bases are soluble in water. All the bases are soluble in water. Understood, children? So the another name of bases we can say it is an alkalis. All the bases are soluble in water. Okay. So then we can say what are the examples for bases. You can give so many bases, that is sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium. your bases. Example, what is the examples? Sodium hydroxide, NaOH, NaOH, and potassium hydroxide, KOH, and calcium hydroxide, CaOH2. Okay, and magnesium hydroxide, MgOH2. Okay, so we can say so many bases. Okay, so these are the examples for bases. In acids, these are weak acids and strong acids. Here, all the bases are soluble in water, so we can say these are all examples for bases. Sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide. So here, children, I'll say one important thing, that is you all must know the molecular formula, the symbols of elements and molecular formula for the compounds. This is very important in chemistry. In your higher classes, this is very important. Okay, children. Okay. Then we move on to the another topic, that is types of indicators. Types of indicators. How to indicate the compound or compounds or acids or bases or salts. How to indicate that? Why we have some indicators? What are the types of indicators? Okay, that is natural indicator, synthetic indicator, and olfactory indicators. So, what are the types of indicators?
Cabbage leaves, turmeric,
okay, and litmus from lichens. These are all natural indicators. And then synthetic indicators. Okay, what are synthetic indicators? Which is made by artificially by the man. Okay, humans. So that we can say it is a artificial indicators or synthetic indicators. Artificial indicators or synthetic indicators. What is the example for synthetic indicators? Okay, that is methyl orange. Methyl orange. Methyl orange and phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein. Okay, so these are all synthetic indicators. Here it is included KNFR also, we have potassium permanganate. These also we are using it as a indicators. Okay, so then we can use these are all synthetic indicators. And then olfactory indicators. So olfactory indicators is differs from these two. Okay, that also we are getting from the natural natural indicators, but that is different from these two. So we are using in our daily life, we are using for cooking, these are all, that is onion, these are all we are using in the olfactory indicators. Understood, children? Okay, so what are the three types of indicators? Natural indicator, synthetic indicator and olfactory indicators. Okay, so in next classes, let us see the chemical properties of acids and bases. Okay, children?